folks, it's Ray DVD here. Welcome to the Movie Reviewers 100 channel again. This week it is H.G. Wells week, and we've had EJ yesterday doing a fantastic review of the original War of the Worlds. It was made in the 50s, and the 50s were just fantastic for these cheesy science fiction films, you know, and I always remember watching it when I was young and being scared of the aliens and stuff. So really good choice, EJ. Now, H.G. Wells, he was a fantastic writer. And he wrote loads of books, and some of them were adapted into films, and it was a difficult choice to pick one. You know, there was The Island of Dr. Moreau, The Shape of Things to Come, etc. But the film I'm going to speak about is one of my all-time favourite Universal Monster films, The Invisible Man. Fantastic film. It was made in 1933. It was directed by James Whale, who directed Frankenstein and The Bride of Frankenstein, so it had a really, really good style. And stars the fantastic Claude Rains. You know, his voice in this film is absolutely amazing. He's in bandages a lot, or he's off screen, you know, portraying the Invisible Man. You know, you see the special effects where you see things just floating in midair and stuff. So a lot depended on his voice, and what a powerful voice he had, you know, and really, really prolific in this film. Basic story is he plays Dr. Griffin, who is a mad scientist. You know, he's invented this invisibility serum, and then we see him, like at the beginning of the film, on the bandages, walking across the snow into an inn. You know, he's wanting to be left alone to his experiments and stuff. Villagers think he's he's been burnt and stuff, so they're curious as well about, you know, this mysterious stranger that turns up. Knowing he causes mayhem in the inn, you know, he's not paying his bills, and they can hear all these sort of noises, and his place is a mess. And then he terrorises the innkeeper, you know, because he's not got, you know, the innkeeper's demanding money and stuff, so he goes absolutely insane, takes off the bandages and runs about in a shirt and stuff, and creates mayhem. Eventually coerces some of his scientist friends to help him. You know, he threatens them, he'll kill them if this Dr. Kemp doesn't help him. So he's wanting to take over the world, you know, he's looping it. So he gets the help of Kemp, you know, but eventually Kemp betrays him, he ends up killing Kemp. And once he kills Kemp, he goes after his love interest, Flora, and he's trying to explain that things to her and stuff, and eventually he takes her away, her and her father. Big sort of confrontation, you know, and then he ends up on the run into a barn, and then the police are after him, you know, they set a light to the barn, and then the last thing we see is his footprints in the snow, he's getting away, and then the inspector shoots him, you know, mortally wounding him. So that's the basic plot. But Claude Rains really is a tour de force in this film. He's absolutely fantastic. Like I say, he's off camera a lot, and it's his voice that really drives the action and drives the intent. You know, you can feel the threatening tones in his voice and stuff. And at the time, this was a really, really... it was like the Avatar of its day, this film. You know, it used a lot of tricks from the theatre and like the latest cinema techniques to create the images of the Invisible Man. You know, it's like they never had blue screen or that then, but they would use black on black, which they used to do, you know, for the puppets in the theatres, you know, and it worked pretty well. Then there was various dissolves, and even like by the standards today, you know, crude visual effects, but they were pretty good for this day. And James Whale, for all his films, he had a sort of an ensemble cast, you know, these sort of English eccentric sort of type of actors. There's the innkeeper's wife in this film is like her shrieks and that are unbelievable, you know. But I like these sort of character actors, you know, I say these are the ones that make interesting films, I believe. And Claude Rains, you know, fantastic in this. The commentary for this film is really, really good, you know, for the film historians and that. And it was saying, like, Claude Rains, he wasn't sure how the audience would take to his portrayal. So him and his daughter sneaked into a cinema one day to watch The Invisible Man, and then he sees there came like a suspenseful bit of the film, and he shouted out something in that Claude Rains voice, and he sees, and the audience members in the front were absolutely terrified, they couldn't believe it. So you get wee sort of anecdotes like that throughout the the commentary on this, and I highly recommend it. You know, it's great if you like your old time films. So that was my sort of brief plot lines of the films. I'm not very good at explaining plots, so I tend to talk about the other things in the films and that. But I hope you enjoyed it anyway. Look out for the guys' reviews during the week. I'm sure they'll be a bit better than mine. And subscribe, leave some comments and stuff. Thanks for watching.